Yeah, it just started. And you're back with me and Potty, which is turned into Mies.
Yeah.
Because Potty's gone out and Mies wanted to cast a fight on me. So I've got him back, the Spock 16 loser who's actually turned into a winner. And you're back with us in the grand final of ET now with Dignitas and the Nexus. Dignitas do have to win twice, so I wonder if they're going to make a repeat of the CIC final that Mies happen to be in.
Yeah, they definitely have a history of a wizard, especially in Enschede, coming back from the loser bracket final and winning twice, CC6, CC7. And,
and CC6, I forgot about that.
It could be a third time for these guys if they play like everyone knows they can.
I don't think they're going to be able to do it, but I can see them doing it. Just because of the history, I can see it happening.
Well, Mao Zan Xylos Ozo lost that CC6 and CC7, so they're going to be feeling the pressure. Like if they win this map and then lose the next, they're going to be thinking, oh god, we can't let this happen again. The pressure's going to be on.
I think that they were thinking about CC7 as well. To be honest, as the an exercise look to push into this CP entrance, and a nice little jump there from Xylos. Actually, he's just jumped in at the top to the by the team door, and Mouse is going to do the same and let them in through the top doorway at this CP. Nobody knows that they're in here yet. Anderson knew actually. Xylos pings a rifle grenade down there. Self kill comes in from Ross, and Xylos is going to open up the fire now. Squiz the team kill onto Xylos. He's going to get gived on a full spot. Mouse with the double grenade as well, and Squiz is going to finish off that, and they're going to take that CP spawn absolutely simply. And Mies, that's almost as good as your win factor attack side.
Yeah, it was pretty good to see. Dignitas is definitely on the back foot here. 2 minutes 13 to the game and already lost and already defending the last radar parts. We're going to go for the classic west defense. I don't think they're going to waste time like trying to defend east. Actually, no, they've got two medics there, so they might be trying to hold on to it for a little while.
Well, the allies have just constructed the command post now. It's Hyatt. Throws a couple of frags into the mix as well before Knight shuts him off. And the Nexus will look to respawn in the next couple of seconds. Dignitas respawning themselves as well. Anderson at this bit of spawn spots somebody over at the fake radar and he's hitting every single bullet, but because of the drop off distance, not going to kill anybody from that range. And we'll now see the Nexus make their way over onto the east radar parts. Mouse is going to be the man to do this. He's going to go for the frag first. Thinks about it. Takes the radar parts. And now he's going to gun it over towards the CP. 20 seconds of respawn left now. Anderson and Knight self-kill.
Great movement there from Mouse.
Yeah, indeed. Quality movement.
I can't watch any more of this. Okay, so now we've got Ross to the main. What's he going to do? He's going to try and look to get someone full, but he's going to take it down by Knight straight away. And the next side are going to have to self-kill and just make sure these East get parts, get in securely, and then go for a main push, it seems.
Yep, they're not going to be making any mistakes like WinFact did the other day on radar, where Squall ran all the way around literally the entire map just to chase the documents. They're going to get the documents home safe and sound. This time Jackass double frag there along with Anderson, picking one up in the mix of things. Jay finally getting one back for the NX side as the team now push through the trenches at this forward bunker, forward hut. And Ross with actually some quite nice aim there, takes out Squall. One of the players is going to try and actually grab the parts. Ross with the pistol. Parts have been taken. Xylos is going to have to retake them. And he's going to get the revive onto his teammate, which is Squiz. And the parts are running off towards the main road. They have been down in the middle of that in the middle of the crossroads. Knight taking them too. Dragon with the third as well. And the parts are still laying down on the floor. Xylos is going to take him out. And I think he's going to get him away. And
oh my god.
And Nexus are going to set 4 minutes and 34 seconds on the first map, which is the exact opposite to what the Dignitas side really, really needed. And I tell you what, Mies, I can't see him winning. I can't see him doing an 8-2 if they're going to be getting hammered that badly.
Well, it definitely wasn't a good map for Dignitas.
Wow.
I don't know, they're known to like give it a turnaround. I remember at CC7 we destroyed them pretty much on the first map, but then somehow supply just they turned it around and brought it back. So it's still possible. If any team can do it, it's Dig. If this was like if Nexus were playing like WinFact or something, I'd be saying like, yeah, it's over. But Dig are like the one team I think could actually bring this back and make this an interesting game.
And there we have it. Professional explanation there from Meez as the match begins. Rifle grenade pinged out to the side. He's going to take out Xylos, which is going to be a bit annoying for the Nexus side early on into this first attack. One medic has been caught off guard in the middle of the road as well. Support fire from Hiya somehow reaching Knight all the way up there in the middle of the mountain. And Felix is coming to say hello again. And the Dignitas side have actually taken that forward bunker, and they're going to get the respawn point there as well. I don't think they're going to lose it. And Squall now finishing off Mouse at that side entrance. Gonna get gibbed as well. And with 10 seconds left to go on this dynamite, an exercise are not gonna have a full strength CP defense because the time it's gonna take for the players to respawn and get over to this CP is gonna be a lot greater than it the time it's going to take the Dignitas side to get into the side exit. But you never know, they might not be able to get in just yet. As Knight fires a rifle grenade into Hiya.
Massive kill from Knight. Oh. Knight with two massive kills there. I think he got two guys on full of the CP.
He definitely got Xylos give, that's for sure. I think Hiya might have gone down as well. Mouse and Squiz now holding off for the entire team now. I think it's Ross on his own at main for the last 5 seconds of respawn as the ally side now try to make their way into
that's
the
a
CP.
Big give
really
from
nice give
on
there
the cover.
From Mouse though. And that's going to be end of that side attack for now as Mouse and Squiz get a couple more frags as they continue to push in. Mouse with the double there and they're all going to pick up the Gibbs. And Nexus have completely shut down that side attack 100% now.
I think Mouse has completely shut down that side attack. I didn't really think of Nexus had much to do with it. It was more just Mouse. But it was definitely well played by him. Crucial Gibbs, crucial frags just when he needed to make them. And it looks like...
looks like a main push actually from the Dignitas
side.
It does
look like a main push.
Grenades get chucked out by Squiz. Hiya with the first MP40 frag. Squiz helping out with the second. And it looks like this Dignitas main rush is a bit pathetic as Mouse and Ross continue to get frags. The revives are coming in. The self kills are going to happen. And the Dignitas side are actually going to go for another two-man main push. Make that three-man main push because Jack has actually stayed out on full as the Nexus side pushed up forward. Squiz is going to get the one frag and now eventually self-kill. Hiya is going to stay out on a full spawn and probably take down Knight as he runs down to the bottom of the crossroads. Yes, he does. Knight's going to respawn and they're up to the CP though.
Oh god, they have two coverts.
I didn't spot that.
What's happening to Dignitas here?
They are properly flopping this and it just seems like... it just seems as if they know they have no chance and they just don't even want to try and get it back anymore. I don't know what's wrong with them. They're just constantly rushing main. They're not even trying to get the CP anymore.
I think when it gets to like 2 minutes left though, you're in the can attack main, like there's too little time to actually get a CP push and get the CP. But Nexus nervous as well, and Nexus are just defending the main with all five guys.
I think they're leaving. I think they've left one person up at the CP the entire last like couple of minutes. So. It's looking pretty good for Nexus so far, and I know we all know that Dignitas can definitely do it. As we said, they're probably one of the only teams that could pull back in a massive 8-map victory, but after watching Raider...
4-map.
Did I say 8 maps?
Yeah.
I meant to say 8 rounds. I do apologise. Well, yeah, you know what I mean. I can't see Dignitas doing it this time around, though. And Nexus just looked far too good for them. And I know
GG
you bashed them at CC7, but they're not going to do it this time. Can't see it happening.
Ye of little faith. Look, they've taken East. They can do this.
They can definitely still do this with the 30-odd seconds left to go on the board. East Raider parts have been taken, and Mouse getting the three-man frag there. Is he going to get the fourth? Squiz is going to get the fourth there. And I think all the Gibbs are going to come in from Ross as he gets the revive onto his teammate there. 20 seconds left. They still have to get the West Raider parts, and they haven't actually secured the East Raider parts in the back of the truck just yet. So, like we said, I think that's going to be that. GG is Ross picks up a three-man as well on the top of that crossroads. 6 seconds left. Squiz with the pistol, Xylos with the MP40. And that's going to be map one done and dusted, not map eight. We're going to have a peek at the scores as I hear the same song for about the 3 millionth time now. And it's getting really great. I love this playlist.
Mao's destroying.
Go over the scores, Mies. I think the second map's Bremen.
I think the scores speak for themselves. Mao's just destroyed them. It wasn't even like... There was... I wouldn't even say a Nexus won that map. I'd just say Mao's won that map.
I think the last time we casted him, Mao's pretty much just won the map for them
as well.
Yeah,
he's getting his sweet, sweet revenge against Stingerton.
He seems to be dominating
now.
Him quite heavily. So annoying. Every single time we restart the round, the FOV changes.
Nice config you have there.
Baggies is config. Baggies who, was changing as well at one stage.
Who was sick last night. Yeah.
Yeah, Baggies who was very, very ill last night, I've heard. What actually happened?
He got depressed about losing with WinFact and decided to drink away his sorrows and couldn't handle it, so...
Oh, fair play. Fair play. I mean, at least he's not dead like Snoop.
Man, we had Overboost. Overboost was way better.
Yeah, I know. I was watching a couple of your games last night. Overboost was well sick. How did you play today?
Amazing. Better than me. But more importantly, this game, which is the grand final, Dig are down one map and they have to win another four maps. No, not eight. Another four maps.
I know.
If they actually want to win. If they lose this, though, if they lose Bremen, then they will lose the LAN tournament. And the Nexus take first place.
But, for the first time.
Yeah. But Dig definitely do have a great defense. And it's going to be... But it's going to be the attack we're seeing from Dignitas this time. Bremen, one of the maps they've been practicing a lot recently. So it's going to be interesting to see how that's paid off. I know I've recently seen them stomp teams like WinFact and Nevo on Bremen. But it's going to be a hard against the Nexus.
With a pretty early aggressive defense here from the Nexus side. Pushing out all the way into the spawn. And all five of the Nexus players self-killing there. And now they're going to play with the five medic strategy that we saw yesterday. As we said, quite a common theme nowadays with the five medics pushing out, always self-killing, and then running out of that flag spawn because it's so safe and secure to be able to do that. But as I say that, they have actually taken the flag from out of nowhere, and Haya continues to get frags around this other part of the map. He's going to throw a grenade down on top of his body, I believe, to give himself so that he can't... Oh, no, he's not going to do it. Maybe that was the wrong option, but maybe they haven't bothered getting the suit. They've just run up through the top with the covert ops. And now the Nexus guys are going to get all the barriers and CPs constructed and everything like that so that the Dignitas side cannot just simply walk in, take this shot.
Oh,
Light with a really nice sniper frag there onto Maus as he was going into that CP room, and I think that might have opened things up for the Dignitas side as he gets another Garand frag. Don't know how he managed to hit that one in midair, and the Dignitas side have somehow rolled this first two stages, and I can't believe 1:30
and they already have the CP, man.
I don't want to call it too early, but this is slightly looking a bit like last time.
If on Bremen, all the time you get on Bremen is spent at the CP stage. If you can't hold the CP stage, then you're not going to set a good time. Like, you're not going to hold it for a good time at all. And they've already, Dignitas already have the CP 1:30 into the game, so.
Jackass is stuck. Nice one. He tried to do a fancy little jump up there as the allies had repaired the truck.
Oh my god.
But they do need to take the key card away, and they do need to plant this truck barrier as well. So we're going to see if they can manage to do that. Ross, Xylos, Maus, and Squiz all fragging the opponent there. And they're going to push out with the grenades and self kill. As they spot nobody respawning at the CP because the grenades were primed a bit too early. They've actually got matching spawn times here. Squall is going to take down Jay on a full spawn here. Squiz with the long range MP40 was trying to stop Jackass from getting a dynamite down on this barrier. Mouse with an MP40 as well, and the documents have actually been dropped somewhere. They've been taken down to the box room, and Knight is running for his life. He's not going to get away from Ross's Luger though.
But the respawn is going
to
come in. Anderson
pick up the frags there just before the documents get reclaimed, and I think he's going to run them all the way home to that generator. The generator's had the keycard put into it now, and the barrier has been planted, and now the allies can move this truck all the way down to the truck barrier. And Mies, Dignitas are playing absolutely incredibly well now after having a shocking game on Raider.
Yeah,
they've really turned things around now, and I think the NX side are getting a bit worried. Everybody seems to be panicking. They don't seem to be playing as much of a unit as they were before. And Xylos goes for his defuse with 6 seconds
left. He's not
going to get it as he gets pushed into the fence and ends up killing himself. How are you doing, Toxic? Learning how to play the game after going out in the group stages and then winning a nice little set of prizes. And Xylos and Mouse going absolutely massive at the truck there, stopping that Dignitas attack from moving the truck any further on. And we're going to see if the Dignitas guys can jump onto it anytime soon as we see Squiz chucking the grenades out. Ross self-kills, and I think that's going to leave a massive hole in the defense for the Xylos to just double rev grenade like that over the fence. Higher with an MP40 as well, but the Dignitas guys are still alive and kicking. But not for long, because Ross and Mouse have shut them down. They've got another respawn now to try and pick off the NX side to get the truck moving. Anderson, really a nice spot there. He turns around, doesn't get the frag off on the Mouse though, and Jackass is going to have to finish him off as Squiz picks off him before he takes the truck any further. And I think the NX side are starting to wake up. They're starting to get their aim back. I think they're starting to get rid of all the nerves that they might have had going into this game, as Drago actually manages to sneak up onto that truck. Mouse with an MP40 there. And it looks like the NX side are just about holding on. Nah, not anymore though. The truck is still moving by Anderson, being moved by Anderson. And the NX side are now chasing after the truck. And Anderson, with absolutely sick headshot there onto Mouse, gets his teammates backing him up at the truck.
It seems to have been too little too late. NX is finally getting some kind of hold on the truck, but
indeed,
it's going to be a 5 minute time.
And which is never too great for Bremen. But they are trying to build the barrier here. Actually, they've got two engineers building the barrier. Revive coming in from the medics. They're going to get the barrier. And the Nexus are going to hold on for another minute at least now, I think, because they're not going to get the dynamite down anytime soon, because I don't think they have any engineers with full charge. As Jakaz has to wait there by the truck barrier until his charge is going to regain itself. Xylos going to look to try and pick off the guy planting, but he's not going to do it quick enough. And he's now going to see if he can get some kind of rifle grenades pinged out towards anybody he sees. And he's going to take a lot of damage there as he jumps out the balcony. Ross and Jay getting a couple of frags here and there. Jackass replies back as well. Ross with the double. And that rifle grenade has gone absolutely nowhere. And Squall's picked up the frag. And I think that they're going to defend this dynamite. Anderson with the two-man frag there at the end. And that dynamite's going to blow in the next couple of seconds. And this truck is definitely going to get escorted all the way, I think. Still playing with four medics and one NG. Are they digging the test side as they self-kill? Anderson respawns, and maybe he's pushing it a bit too much there. He wasn't pushing in as a unit, but Squall's coming from the back along with Jakaz, and Drago is going to finish off the final frag against the NX side there on Bremen. And pretty convincing time moves.
Yeah, they need to... It's pretty convincing. Obviously, getting the barrier up has definitely helped NX though, because... Until that barrier went up, I'd have said Dig had already won this map, but at 6:21, that's a beatable time. You can attack that, and you can still like use many attacks in the CP phase, which Nexus will look to do, I guess. And it's a beatable time. If they want to keep it simple, they just beat this, and they've won the Sage LAN.
Yeah, exactly. So it's technically the pressure is, well, as much as the pressure is on for Dignitas to come back in to actually come back from this. In a way, the pressure is just as much on the Nexus, because this will be the first LAN that, well, the first LAN that they'll actually win as a team against the team that seems to always dominate at LAN. So here we go. Are the Nexus guys going to set a faster time than 6 minutes and 21 seconds? We're going to find out in due course as they start their main rush now. Squiz is going to lead the charge probably with the med packs as the airstrikes get thrown out. Knight and Drago open the frags up early on for Dignitas side. Jackass with the support fire as well. And now with 6 minutes left, Xylos is just going to chill out at the top of the ruins here as he sees a grenade get chucked over towards him. He dives out the back and takes on Squall near this main gate in the firefight. Ross is going to come and back him up, but I think he's going to run away from him, and he's going to try and get the frag under Anderson at the arches. He's not going to come out too successful. Self-kills, and now the NX side have to set up another attack onto this flag stage. Would have been a much more of a dream start if they got that flag on the first rush meets, but I guess we were expecting them not to do that.
You can never take the flag on the first version, Brayman, unless the Axis do something stupid. It's just they all push out and there's an airstrike and it's too difficult. And Knight is going to make a massive kill onto Mouse there on his full spawn. I think Ross might... Yeah, Ross goes down on full spawn as well. The Nexus team's not doing much with their spawn time at all at the moment. Squiz picks up two, but it's going to be not enough because the revive's going to come in now and has the self-kill. That was a terrible spawn for Nexus. They just didn't use his time at all. Ooh. And Dignitas have time to self-kill and set up another defense.
It looks as if it's going to be a full hold on this first flag stage as well, because at the moment, all I can see is Dignitas absolutely dominating at the moment. Squiz pushing in for the flag now. Ross with an absolutely terrible support fire there. Just as you thought they were going to get the flag, two men go down from Ross, and they're not going to be too happy with his with him throwing airstrikes like that at this time, at this stage of the map. Squiz jumps onto that little roof just by the flag. They know the Axis have respawned, and he's going to go for one of his wonder grabs now. 3 seconds of respawn left. He dives to the flag, but he's not going to reach it. And he's going to take a full spawn as well. And Mies is going to run away from me. While the final will go on. Jakar's holding the flag with Anderson, who gets the revive on the night. Double frag there from Squall as Mouse and Jay pick up two for the Nexus side. And they're going to continue to push on forwards for this flag. 5 seconds left for the Dignitas side to hold the flag on for Mouse self-kills. And Nexus still have not got that flag in their possession as Squiz and Ross move on pretty swiftly towards the middle of the map, towards the ruins. Grenade chucked out by the Dignitas side, pushes Squiz all the way out towards his main gate. And he's now going to challenge Squall and somebody else at the end of the at the end of that main road. 3 minutes 43 left on the board. Hire with a double Thompson frag there, Xylos with the team frag onto Hire. And it looks like the Nexus side might actually get it this time as the frag comes in from Jakaz though, and manages to stop Squiz dead in his tracks. And it looks to me as if the Dignitas side are going to hold on once more to this flag stage. And with 3 minutes 20 left on the board, I don't know if anybody around here knows how exactly what the fastest time is on Bremen. Well, I don't think you're going to do it in 3 minutes 10 against Dignitas, especially when they're defending at this quality. As Jakaz holding that flag, he's doing an absolutely brilliant job there. And now they've actually taken the crazy option of taking a covert ops now, because they have no other realistic option but to take a covert ops, get a suit and run through the door and try and get all the objectives done that way. But when Knight's getting double MP40 frags like that with Anderson backing him up, I don't think there's a lot you're going to be able to do. And with 2 minutes 40 left on the board, that's a definite GG for this map, I'd say. Knight pushing forward the Luger. There's a Dynamite going down on the main gate now. Knight's looking forward to try and stop it. He's not going to get it though. Two frags go down up there for the Dignitas side, as well as the Nexus side. Dragon with the third. And the Dynamite is clear for them to defuse if they have an Engineer, but I don't believe they do. And it means that the Dignitas side are going to be forced back to the second stage, finally. Which is what they needed to realistically be doing about 3 or 4 minutes ago, but Doesn't look as if they're going to be setting a time anytime soon. With Dignitas already in position at this CP stage. Anderson getting a frag here and it, as well as Drago. Still pushed out at this flag. An Nexus self-kill. And now Ross is going to move on towards his keycard. Keycard has been stolen though. I'm not sure who's actually got possession of the key card, but he's running across the top. Drago goes for a last minute save. Squiz is going to take him out, and the documents are going to get put into the generator. And just as I'm saying that it's definitely a GG, they've actually managed to do 2 of the 3 final objectives literally at the same time. So it's going to be a very last minute defense here from the Dignitas side as the FMV gets put out on the main road. 1 minute and 18 seconds left on the board. Drago with an MP40 frag there, as well as Squall, and GG there from Ross. So we're going to be moving into a third map and possibly another set of maps. Because if Dignitas do manage to win this, they have to win it twice if they do want to win the entire LAN. And talking of LANs, got the PHX Phoenix LAN or whatever it's called. I think it's called the PHX LAN in Swansea coming up pretty soonish. So if you've got any ET people listening, make sure you... make sure you get signed up for that event, because I'm pretty sure it'll be a nice event run by Merlinator and some other people, I believe. I can't remember who exactly is running it except for Merle, to be honest, but I know he's in charge. He's one of the boss mans. And I'm not sure what the third map is. Do you know how you decide the third map? Do you have to just eliminate again, or? Oh. Anderson with the face rape there. Oh my god. Almost got a 3 Luger headshot frag there. That would have been pretty tidy to be, that would have been pretty tidy to show off in a movie or something. And, Dignitas are somehow keeping themselves in this game, and I really don't know how, because they don't deserve it. They haven't been playing good enough to be at this stage in the competition, and now all of a sudden they're starting to play incredible. And I don't want to say it, but I can see an 8-2 in sight. So at the moment we've got a 2-2 as the score in the Inexus Dignitas match, and it's now going to be the decision of the teams to throw out the maps. I can't see it being Frostbite or Adlanest, so I'm preparing myself for a good old Supply or Gold Rush, which will be fantastic. Open the console. Always Tails. I should go for the real coin toss. So, just waiting for them to eliminate the maps, and me should be back with me kind of shortly, I'd hope. Because at the moment, I've got nobody to talk to. Except for people sat next to me, and they're just laughing at me suffering. Do you know who Spot 16 won in the Constellation final? Who they actually beat? Ah, right, okay. Right. Yeah. All right, then. Well, yeah. Spot 16, even though they did go out in the groups, managed to pick up, I think they picked up 5 SteelSeries mouse pads, which is quite nice. So they're not going to go home empty-handed. So Snoop, unfortunately for him, is not going to be getting a mouse pad because he's gone. No, I don't think anybody knows where Snoop is, actually. He's just disappeared, and I don't think we're going to see him for a while. And actually, Gold Rush has been chucked out, which I am absolutely chuffed to bits about, because that means Adlanest or Frostbite. Oh, yeah. I reckon they're going to go for Frostbite just for the mentality. Oh, for... Frostbite.
Hello, Ozo. How are you doing?
I'm pretty upset, to be completely honest with you.
You wanted Frostbite.
I did, yeah. And
check out what I won.
It's a nice-looking mouse pad you got there.
It is a nice-looking mouse pad.
It's a SteelSeries mouse pad. Right, I'm going to quickly go to the toilet, and you can speak to anybody else around. If anybody wants to jump on, just put the headset on. I'll be back in 2 minutes.
Excellent. So is it Supply of Decider, yeah?
Yes.
All right, cool. I guess you're stuck with me then, unfortunately. Anexus, this is a good map for Anexus, but Dig, as we saw at CT7, when Knight absolutely tore apart a rocket side at a very crucial stage in the game. So they can definitely perform under pressure on this map. But is it going to be enough for this Anexus side, who definitely have the ambition and definitely have the desire to win this LAN? I just don't know. I just don't know. This is definitely the game to watch of the LAN. It's probably going to be the highest quality game. I mean, there's been some upsets, like Dig losing to Nevo, who came third, and Spot 16 going out in the group stage, but of all the games, I'd say this is the one you don't want to miss. This is the round you need to see. A Dignitas attack on Supply. And personally, I think it's going to be a good one. It needs to be a good one. But if it isn't, they'd put themselves in a really bad light to win this final. It's I think if they set more than 10 minutes, Anexus will have no problems beating it. It's got to be fast. They've got to show dominance. And I think they're going to have a few tricks up their sleeves, as they usually do. This thing is the side. And we're going to be going live now. This game is starting in 7 seconds, 6. And I don't need to do a count now because I'm on the stream, which I forgot, I'm afraid. And Ozo still hasn't rejoined me, so I'll have to take you through the play-by-play. And we're in eyes of Mouse at the moment, who's playing the medic at lower with Squiz. Jack has double rifle grenade, but a double rifle grenade as well from Xylos straight up in reply. Mouse now is going to sit here and take out two, takes out three. Big triple kill from Mouse. And the Dignity side are going to have to respawn and push forward again. Mouse making his way forward, and he's eventually going to go down only to himself with a self kill. But I think Jay may have got fuller. No, he didn't. Jacka, what can Jacka do here? Jacka's going to go in. It looks like the Dignity side are getting down now. And this is a big rifle frag onto the rifle versus rifle. Jacka comes out on top, and he takes out Ross with a massive double headshot. And Jacka takes this flag. In less than a minute, Dignity have the flag, and it's looking pretty secure. They hope they're going to switch out some NGs now and get these plans made. 1 minute is a very, very rapid time. Ozo is just rejoining me now. He's making his way back from the toilet. And I'll update him. So, Dig have the flag in 1 minute.
I can't believe this is happening. Yeah. Right, so basically, Digger tasked a steamrolling in the first stage of supply. And they just wait for the doors to blow up right now. And typically enough, the time I go to the toilet when I'm chancing it the most, both toilets are locked. So I have to wait there. But never mind, because we're back in action now, and the Anexus side are going to look to set up a pretty strong defense and crossfire up at this top part of the map. And, every time I seem to watch them play, they seem to have a pretty sick crossfire up here. So let's see if they can repeat some more of this sick crossfire. And as Ross gets a frag on the light, Jack has self-kills, and the rest of the Dignitas side are now going to respawn and regroup to push over towards the CP where the look of things. And actually, I think a couple of people, because of that FFE, have gone down the cave. At least Squall has, as Jay gets a double MP, a double frag there. Xylos finishes off Squall in that cave. And Xylos is now going to be hanging out down around by this main gate. Mouse with a double MP40 there as well. Squall continuing to go down the cave. And what was the biggest factor of why they got the flag on such an early time, Mouse?
The Nexus self-killed, and they basically just pushed in all together at the right time. All five of them pushed in, all five were shooting, and the Nexus were out of position.
Because they did exactly the same thing Evil this morning as well, where they just got the flag on the first rush.
It wasn't exactly the first rush, but it was probably the second push. They just pushed down all five, and it was a very, very fierce attack. But not as fierce as Mouse, who takes out Knight in the tunnel. But it's Jackass is gonna construct that CP, and 3 minutes in, it looks like the CP stage is down as well. And Nexus looking in pretty bad shape here, if I'm totally honest. Knight is gonna get this plant down on the main. They're not gonna be able to stop him. But Mouse, even with a triple kill, it's just not enough to stop. Mouse with four, actually, a George four man. And they might even be able to get this defuse. Oh no, they won't, because Drago's still there.
Oh my god, Mouse. Another four-man kill there. Anderson
serious?
Picking up two as well. But I'm not sure if they're going to get the defuse. Even though Mouse seems to be going absolutely wild, the Axis side is still not going to get this defuse. I cannot believe that. I think he just got about eight frags there. And the dynamite has still been blown up. And, well, I don't understand how he's managed to do that. And they still haven't managed to get the defuse, so that's kind of proving what the Dignitas guys are doing. Even though they're getting demolished by this one guy, Mouse, they're still managing to steamroll them through the map. 10 minutes 56 seconds now on the board, and the Anexus side must definitely be panicking now. Even Mouse, who seems to be just absolutely on fire, is going to be panicking. Going to be panicking now, and the thoughts of the last CLC7 final are surely creeping into his head. And if it was Frostbite, I'd imagine it would be even worse.
That's probably why we didn't use Frostbite, to be honest. I don't think Xylos and Miles could cope with that stress.
Mouse holds his own again at this main gate. Picking off Jakaz. And the likes of Knight at the east exit. The truck is just sitting here in that main gate, which is a bit difficult to actually attack with, because it's just, you know, the truck is just sitting there. And it's like, you can only come two ways of the truck, obviously. And he's not got a lot of space to move. And Mouse continues to go around hitting every single shot. And I tell you what, Mouse is going to be absolutely furious if they don't pick up this game for sure, because he's having an absolute storming game so far. As the truck is about to get moved by the Dignitas side, Knight makes the initial push with the rifle. Ross picks him down, and they're going to get the give onto him as well. I see an extra side push out towards that main gate. Dignitas respawn. Squiz looking to get a couple of picks off at the double doors just before he self-kills. Knight goes for the trick jump over the east wall and somehow doesn't make it. As he shoots a rifle grenade off the west bunker now as he makes the push in, and he self-kills straight away. 9 minutes, 16 seconds on the board. Score with a two-man frag there. Squiz also opening up things to the NXT side, and I think with Drago and Anderson getting those two frags just then.
Oh, that's massive.
They've managed to steal the truck and put it all the way to the back of the crane, and now everything relies on the Nexus up top defense. If they can actually get up top, Squiz is the last man standing. They have respawned. Are they going to catch him as they run up the stairs? Anderson is waiting outside. And I think the rest of the Nexus team are going to run up the back. Knight with a grenade there on the stairwell. He's going to tap the box and then probably run away because of the Panzer. Ooh. And the Panzer from Ross shoots it past the head of the medic trying to block the doorway. And they're not going to get this construction point.
I'm not even sure how that happened. I'm sure the medic was in front of the door. Did he like not block it enough?
I think he's just shot at the top left over his head. Basically.
It's a rookie error from Dignitas dying to a Panzer like that. This game was pretty much in the bag for them. And it could be that Ross's Panzer, I hate to say it, but it could be that Ross has saved a Nexus here.
I don't even want to imagine what Ross is going to be like if he takes that as the winning factor of the game. But either way,
it will definitely be a decisive one if they can actually hold this, which I don't think they can. Squiz left on his own here. It takes down two. Takes down maybe three. No, Jackout is going to be okay.
He's going to run up the top as an engineer. I don't think. Okay, Squiz is now chasing him, and so is Mouse. He's going to have to chuck grenades down in his path as Jay gets a double MP40 frag there. Jackass gets the pliers onto the building box. And my god, again, Mouse with a save. Grenade in the face of Jakaz when he tries to get the button pressed to get the gold in the back of the truck. And the Nexus side is somehow still just about holding on as Drago goes to get the push. And Anderson can't get the revive. Mouse with another crucial two-man. And I can't believe this guy. Mouse is playing absolutely out of this world at the moment.
Score's going to go down there.
Dignitas side will respawn again and probably make a quick push through the main. Anderson leading the charge, almost catches that grenade thrown over the west wall, and Ross is going to take out Anderson straight away. Jay's going to help out as well, but Dignitas getting a couple of frags back for themselves. Jakaz going to be the third one to frag Ross down. Xylos picks off one of the engineers and gets him gibbed up that middle level, which is really crucial. Nice shooting there from Ross as well, actually. He's going to take a lot of damage from Drago's pistol there. And Jakaz now making his way through the main gate. He's got Haya with another three-man MP40 there. Every single game I've spec'd of him, he seems to just constantly hit three-mans and four-mans, whether it's with FFE or MP40. He seems to be the man to watch, and with Mouse doing pretty much exactly the same thing. I think they're finally starting to get some kind of rhythm back, and they've kicked the nerves out this system, because they've been a lot more aggressive than they were originally planning to be with. They all just literally ran up top because they were worried about the engineer getting past them. Squall at this west wall now takes down Jay.
Yeah, I'm definitely enjoying this new Nexus defense. It's
kind of crazy.
It's better to see than what they were doing before. Basically, they never took risks. They never pushed out. They just basically
did what Xylos is doing now, but with all five people.
Yeah, exactly. And against a lot of teams, you know, that's probably a good idea. But against Dig, you have to take risks. If you don't take the risks against Dig, they're just gonna stomp you. You have to take the risk and hopefully you get lucky. Hopefully you can hold it.
I'm not sure if anybody does manage to get up, actually. Oh, Mouse is here now. Never mind. But I was about to say the two people that were originally up. For a start, they didn't have full HP. And second of all, they didn't even have a medic with them. But Mouse is up there now. And here comes the Dignitas side. Anderson gets the first frag. Squall was going to be leading the charge now. He's going to take down Ross with a pretty nice headshot. Rifle grenade there from Xylos. He's going to put a stop to this push at the moment. Jay with another MP40, Knight eats his own rifle grenade, and Mouse just putting more frags on the console, and it just looks to me as if Mouse is the only one that can stop it. But Xylos in the back finishes off Anderson and Jakaz, and I don't think there's another engineer up top just yet. Knight with a double Garand frag down at the bottom of the of this supply depot stage. Primes a rifle grenade, waiting for the Axis to respawn. Squall with a team code revive. Only 5 minutes, soldier. In a pretty awkward spot for him to get out of, because now he's got the Axis respawn to deal with, and he's going to take a full spawn. Maybe he should have gone up into the stairs instead of trying to shoot them from just behind the spawn. And for some reason, the Dignitas side have just been leaving their engineers on their own for the last couple of minutes now. I'm pretty sure that Jakaz has just been picked off on his own a couple of spawns now. As we see one of the Nexus players move up to the top of this wall. He's going to peek around the corner. It's Jay who's going to run frantically after that engineer. Jakaz is going to get the frag on him in the end. Mouse self-kills. And now here comes the Dignitas side once again. Rifle grenade pinged out from Knight, and what did look to be a pretty convincing time, Mies, has been shoved into a pretty awkward kind of average time if they actually finish it.
Yeah, indeed. It's not looking good for them at the moment at all. I don't even think they can set a time here.
He doesn't think they're going to set a time now?
At this rate, no. They need to change something if they want to. Because normally on supply, like, if you have a lot of momentum, you sort of need to slow it down for this phase. It's like you can't play it with the same speed of the CP or the first stage. And they seem to be just like still having too much speed, but the medics are just gassing away from the engineers, and it's just not enough. They definitely need to focus more on their team play. Yeah. It's rare someone says that about Dignitas, but that's true at the moment. The team play is just lacking a little bit.
Indeed, I'd imagine Knight would be pretty angry at the moment, because if Nexus do win this map, then that's going to be it, and that's going to be Nexus winning the grand final. But if Dignitas do manage to pick this map up, which is supply, then they have to play another set of maps, which could actually result in Dignitas winning the LAN. Obviously, if they do win both sets of maps. Dragon out, reviving his teammate Knight, who hasn't had a revive for quite a while now. He's pushing in on his own, squeeze at that middle level. Does a bit of damage and then runs off. He's now at the bottom of the stairs. Two-man frag for Squiz, and he's going to get both of the Gibbs there. Really well done there from Squiz. Getting the one knife Gib onto the engineers. And now an Nexus J fragging down Squall once again. Knight taking his time to jump in through the east wall this time. And he's now going to run all the way around the back as I have a quick scan for the engineer. And again, the engineer, for some reason, completely on his own. I know they decided just about to respawn, but I don't understand why there's never a medic with him, ever. I said, I'm going to have a watch of the engineer because he's never ever got a medic with him, I swear. As the rifle continued to come smashing into the Dignitas's face through this depot gate.
I want to see where Knight is. What's Knight up to?
And Knight's just died to Ross's MP40. Oh. As Squiz chucks a grenade out to the east exit. 2 minutes 13 left on the board.
This is pretty much the last attack now for Dignitas.
Indeed.
If they don't make something of this, then it's going to be over. Jagger coming in on the Squiz, but Squiz is prepared. He's going to take him down. And it looks like Nexus have this. A full hold.
Yep, I think you're right there. I don't think that they're Dignitas are going to be able to set a time, especially with all the Nexus players just running up the top now. They're going to run up and just hold off at least one or two waves. Well, if that, they're just going to hold off the one attack that's going to come in pretty soon, and then after that, it's going to be a GG, I think. Rice rifle grenade there from Xylos. Not getting any gibs yet, though. Squall turning around, getting the first frag of the Dignitas push, and that revive's coming in like crazy, but again, no engineers just quite yet. And there goes the engineer running in now. Mouse with the two-man frag. Is he going to get any more? Yes, he is going to get more. He's got three on the board now, and he's not going to get the kill on the engineer. And he's going to get the kill and the gib onto the engineer with the knife, and that's going to be GG, I think.
Yeah, definitely.
Unless Knight comes out of nowhere with the rifle and builds the construction point, but I don't think he is. 1 minute left to go. Xylos double rifle grenade, taking down the second engineer, and that is definitely going to be GG with 54 seconds left on the board. What do you think? Nexus can definitely do this? Then do you think Nexus feel comfortable enough to set a time now, or is it going to be a double full hold?
Well, they have, obviously, they have lots of time to set a time, but I don't know. I actually don't know. If it was any team except Dig, I'd say yeah, they're going to win this. But Dig, you can't predict it. You just honestly can't predict what's going to happen. They could sudden they could like have a little break, talk about it, and all of a sudden pull out an amazing defense and just flag hold them or something. You just never know, man.
This is very true. And, with Supply being one of the more... How would you describe Supply as a map?
What do you mean?
As in, one of the more tactical maps or not?
I'd say...
I think nowadays it's a lot less like that.
Yeah, in 5-on-5 definitely changed it. It's sort of like... 5-on-5 has definitely changed like the flow of the map. But I don't know. It's all about... It's essentially always been about your team play. Like... Well, maybe not even so, because mixers do pretty well on it. It's basically just like playing for the team, and you can have. It also lets individual players shine. Like a fop, if you have a good fop up, they will rack in the damage, and it's just situations like that. Especially up, it caters for like players like Maus, who can just go sick and get like massive free mans in clutch moments, and it's definitely a map that favors a Nexus, I'd say, so I'm not sure why they have taken it.
Well, I would have said after the first rush that Dignitas were going to win this, take it to a second set of maps, but now that they haven't set a time at all, I can't see it happening now. I reckon we're going to see a Nexus time set here. Just waiting for one more guy to rip, which is Jackers. I guess they're going over things, how they're going to do it. And then when they finish going over things, they should be able to ready up pretty swiftly. You having a good day, Moose?
I'm having a good day. Are you having a good day?
No.
Okay,
no Frostbite, no Antlernest. I'm having a shocker. But either way, the match is going to begin with an Nexus dropping down the ammo packs for the other medics that are going to be respawning with them, and I guess the field up is going to self-kill now. Which was Xylos, I think, who's going to go engineer. And here we go. It looks like every single player from the Nexus side are all going up. Jay with the first Thompson frag for the allied side. Dignitas self-kill, and Squish is going to dive down towards the lower part. Going to get a couple of frags for the Dignitas side as well, though. Drago with an MP40 frag to finish things off. Mouse self-kills. We're going to see what the Nexus side can do on the second push. It's 14 minutes, 19 left on the board. Mouse with the Thompson frag there. Squiz also helping his teammates out with the Thompson frag. And a lot of frags on both sides now. It's pretty even in the amount of people who are left alive at the moment. Dignitas are going to respawn. And this person at the window, I've forgotten his name.
Mouse
is going to chuck a grenade into the spawn and get nothing done. And as I finally find him, he's going to go down and get killed. A squish grenade in through from the cave up through the window. Ross moving forwards, gets a really, really nice give onto one of the players into this in this top room. Jackass at the cave side stairwell, trying to hold onto the flag along with his teammate Drago, and I'm not sure where Drago's gone. Here he is, and he's going to go down. Ross is going to cult him in the face, and they've actually set, well, I think they've basically got it at exactly the same time as Dignitas got it, because I remember when I got back, it was 13:37.
No, it was a little slower, but there's not really much in it, indeed. It's definitely going the same way of the Dignitas attack. Maybe Dig can change it around when they get to the depot and hold them again for like the full. And it looks like your Nexus is having fun pushing each other around here.
That's when you just want to see a typical Kams Panzer opening the door. Nice. Killing them all on short spawn.
I think you want a baggies team kill grenades. Definitely.
A hentai team kill grenade.
Hentai team kill grenade, indeed.
That was terrible. Either way, Knight with a double kill there. Drago with the third. Xylos. Oh, yes, Knight. Double rifle grenade there, shutting down that attack. And they're going to have to respawn and move right across the top as a Nexus Ross decides to just run off the edge and break his legs. As he now makes the push towards the CP, nice little dodge over there. Squiz is going to get the revive on him there. Really, really great revive in there from Squiz, as per norm. Knight with a K43 frag as well in the mix of things. And Ross just waiting for the co-ops to get there. Actually, from behind the stairs, he completely outsmarted Jakaz there. And Knight, oh my god, manages to tap the CP before Ross can get it. I don't know how he's managed that. Ross has 8 HP. He's going to get down by Squalor. Knight might have just saved the Axis side from losing that CP straight away, but while they've lost that, the Axis side have moved on down towards the depot gate, and they're going to get a dynamite planted on that pretty soon, I guess. Nope, Xylos is going to take far too long, and for some reason triple landmine, and where I thought it was going to be pretty good for the NXT side, it's kind of turned out quite badly, because they've got no Deeper Gate planted, but they have now built the CP, so...
No, they... Oh, you know, yeah, they have built the CP, sorry, I thought it was destroyed.
No, they... Knight did something pretty cool earlier.
But it looks like they're going to get a plant now as well on the main gate, unless Knight can stop them. I don't think he has enough time. Dialos is definitely going to arm this plant, and Ross is there as well. They're going to self-clear. It looks like they're going to be able to set up a nice crossfire on the plant with five guys. Oh. I can't see a way for Dig to defuse this. Jacket and Knight both there, once again without medics, reminiscent of their attack. But Fry's coming in from Squall and Drago, and Knight's going to shoot his rifle away, but he's not going to get anything.
Don't think he can, with
a massive triple kill, one Thompson, two support fire, is going to stop Dignitas from having any chance of defusing. And they have 10 minutes to hold this last stage.
That is not looking too good for the Dignitas side just yet. Knight shoots a rifle grenade into the east tower, which takes out Jay. Dignitas getting a lot of frags here. Xylos must have been a shot there from Xylos with the Garan frag. That was pretty sick indeed, as Anderson also goes down to squeezes Thompson, who then gets an instant revive from his teammate Mouse, and it's all about moving the truck through this depot gate now as Mouse pushes on forward, tries to get Knight Gib, but he's not going to even frag him down before he can even think about going for the Gib, as grenades come over that west wall, finally hits Ross in the face. Dynamite planted. And I really cannot stand this song anymore, as Knight throws a couple of grenades over the east wall. He's probably going to take down the engineer planting this time, which is Xylos, and there's no dynamite going to be planted at the east wall with that rifle grenade giving the engineer. And grenades coming over off the spawn from the ally side now. They are completely ignoring the truck for some reason. They want to do trick jumps instead. But Jace finally realized that he failed the jump, and he's got to go back for the truck anyway. He's now going to be the man to escort it, with him rushing it on a full spawn now. And I can smell burning. Don't know why. But Jay is now going to be backed up by the rest of his teammates. He's going to run in here, get grenaded backwards after getting fragged by Jakaz. Squiz coming in with all the revives here as Jay just decides to move around to the west gate and dive in through the wall at the west instead of going through the main gate and getting pummeled by a massive Dignitas crossfire. He's going to come into a firefight with Squall. Squall's going to take him out. And the Nexus side still have an absolute age to get this stage completed. So I'm pretty sure that they won't be worrying just yet, Mies.
No, indeed. It looks like Squiz is nice to sneak in and take the truck home. Need massive frag onto Drago on full spawn. He's going to get the Gib as well. Dig have no choice but to fall back. And it looks like they're split up. Anderson left alone a bit east. Knight with a double rifle grenade frag onto Ross and Jay. Massive kill there from Knight. Jakar picking up the stragglers. That was a crucial moment. It was nearly going to be all over for them. But they've got the key kills. And Knight is absolutely destroying this Nexus attack with two more kills on the board. Three more kills on the board. That's five kills this spawn for Knight. And even Xylos is going to go down, who's coming in that west tower. And Dignitas looking quite strong at the moment, actually. I think they can do this.
With 8 minutes to go, it's going to be a pretty tight one anyway. Nexus trying to make their way through the main gate now. Dignitas winning the battle of the frags at the moment. We've got Jay, double rifle grenade from Knight on his teammates.
Team kill.
Which is not what you want to be doing, but it doesn't matter because they've instantly respawned anyway. So the Nexus side pushing in. They're doing a bit of a Dignitas now where the engineers have no medics with them. But Xylos, don't know where he shot that rifle grenade from. But managed to pick off Jakaz just there.
Just you can't always blame the medics, though. Sometimes it's the engineers who run off. The engineer, especially with Ross, I think, who was like more of a medic player, sometimes forgets he's playing engineer and will just sprint off into the distance. But that isn't going to ruin those times. Anderson takes out both engineers and a medic. Two with his grenade, one with his Thompson. And that's another attack shut down by this Dignitas side, giving Knight time to get some mines down and reset up his east defense. With 7 minutes still left to hold, it's definitely possible. And a double full hold on supply would definitely say a lot about the state of 5-on-5, I think. But double frag from Mouse, double frag from Anderson. And the dig side where they are going to respawn and try and, I think they're going to fall back here a little bit. Yeah, they're looking
like they're going up to just hold the outside of the spawn here. We're nice on top of those boxes opposite the spawn exit. As the NX side make the push in now, there's a massive, massive cluster of players in that middle that middle room, but they've managed to disperse now.
Only two left.
As they start to fall up, Drakkar's with the MP40,
two on five.
Backing his teammate up, and he's going to get a lot of headshots, but he's not going to get any frags. Anderson and Drakkar's just down to Lugas now, and pretty low HP. Squiz is going to make the initial push in. He's going to get the first frag. Anderson's going to get the Luger, but Squiz is going to finish it with the knife. Knight with a double grenade, though, and the rifle's coming up through the window. I think he's going to stop a plant again. Gets a knife grenade onto Ross. I didn't hear a gibbing sound. He has been revived. There's two engineers up there anyway. And Ross is still going to push the button, even though Knight is constantly getting frags. Frags up there, and Nexus are still rolling through the map with 6 minutes, 10 seconds left on the board. Squall waiting
that
on that truck.
So unfortunate for Knight, like he made so many frags, but Nexus got a little bit lucky and got the revives. There was no Gibbs. And Dig in pretty poor form at the moment. The pressure's got to be on.
Nice Squiz,
he's going to take out Squall, but he's going to go down to Jaka. And Knight picked up 2k43 full for himself. And a Nexus just freshly respawned. Hopefully, they don't want to waste any time. They're probably thinking, oh, yeah, we don't want to rush this. We've got loads of time. But at the same time, they do have to set a time to win this LAN. And if they don't, I think it definitely puts Dig in a good stead to win the LAN. But at the moment, it's 5 minutes left, and the Nexus are very, very strong. Mao's going to chill out here at the main, aim terribly. In fact, aim very terribly, but still kills Drago, using his whole clip to do that. And Miles and Jay moving forward now to the back. And it looks like Jay, Miles, and Ross are all on this truck. But Ross is going to go down, and Miles misses the revive, even aiming terribly with his syringe at the moment. And Drago and Knight are going to clean up at the back there.
As Nexus do respawn and push him back through this east wall, Squiz is going to be the man to do that. Really great shot onto Knight, gets him gibbed, and he's going to make his way onto the truck as he comes into contact with Drakkar's and takes a full spawn. It's not what the Welsh wanted to do there, as the Nexus are pushing through the main now. Score with the first frag, Anderson with the Gibb on the mouse as well, and that's going to really annoy the Nexus side. Xylos with the ground frag, and they're going to clean up the mess at main, and also frag the two people at the back of the east. I don't know how Squall managed to get Ross there. He could barely see his legs. But he's managed to pick up the frag and force the entire Nexus side back to this stage again. 4 minutes and 17 seconds. Grenade onto Squiz there. Does a lot of damage just to have to hit it once with the MP40. Mouse goes down to Squall's MP40 again as well. And Ross has somehow managed to sneak onto the truck. It's as if nobody's watching the west and all they have to do is walk in. Ross does get taken down in the end, though, after diving in the back of that truck. Knight and Squall holding off the east wall.
Squall a little confused at who his teammates were for a second.
Yep, he's a bit trigger happy at the moment, but Mouse is pushing in through the east wall now. Takes down Knight. Not going to come any. He's not going to get anything out of this, though, as Knight gets another K43 frag. Squiz with the Thompson frag on a Knight. The entire Dignitas side down and out now, and the truck is going to continue to move around the back of the east. 3 minutes 30 left on the board, and team kills coming in from Xylos as well as Squall.
But he's made up bricks. He's took out two, maybe even three, but no, he goes down to Jaka. And Knight as well picking up Squiz. Ross dying to a landmine, and Dignitas do actually have another attempt to setting up his defense, but Miles is going to tear it apart from the inside, and he's actually going to get down by Squall. And they both spawned at the same time now, so Dig have a little bit of time to set up a defense. 3 minutes left on the clock. The pressure is on both teams. I can't imagine what they must be going through right now. Well, I can, but
of course you can. I mean, you got a 9882 in the final of CRC7. Of course you know what's going on as Jay gets a double Thompson frag there. Gets to take a full spawn again, though. And I think they're being a bit irrational now with taking in far too many full spawns. I think I've seen quite a few plays. I think I've seen quite a few rushes now. Sorry, they've just been rushing with four instead of five. But they've managed to get into east now.
Miles and Xylos to move this truck. But Nova Nox, Anderson comes in with a double kill. And Jacko with a team kill onto Drago on a full spawn as well. That's definitely not what you need. 2 minutes left, and Squiz going huge at the back, tearing apart this Dignitas side. 3 kills from Squiz, and Ross and Xylos pick up frags as well. This truck's moving now through the main gate. GG called by Jaka and Knight, and it looks like a Nexus have won Sage.
Yeah, indeed. I actually didn't even tip them for winning. I thought they were going to bottle it in the final. They almost did, I suppose, but I think they got their act together now, and they've managed to pull it back and win, and finally beat Dignitas in the final.
13-8, I think the odds were on Paddy Power. So they were the favourites for this LAN, and yeah, rightly so, because they have come through and won it. And I can hear them cheering. They must be happy with that.
Well, Mouse, all I'm saying, Mouse, 10k damage. What can you do?
That, honest this to final God. Was won by Mouse.
Mouse has had the best game of the tournament, I reckon.
This
just
is,
in
yeah.
that one game.
He's this is his revenge. Sick. This is revenge for Mouse. After CC6, CC7, 2-8 map losses. No, 4 map losses to Dignitas.
Exactly.
He's finally got his revenge.
And, but he's pretty happy with that. I think they're going over to shake hands now. So, do you know the prize fund and everything for the winners? I can't remember, to be completely honest with you.
It's 2,000, I think, isn't it? 2,000 euros for the winner?
I really can't remember.
Yeah, 2,000 euros for the winner, 1,000 for an exit, for Dignity, sorry. 1,000 for the second place.
Well, they can't be too unhappy with that then.
And I think Nevo took home 500 euros as well with their third place finishing.
Their third place, yeah. So, Mies, after the entire event, who's been your player of the event, of the entire event?
Well, MVP has to be Mouse just for this game. Like, he has destroyed Dig. He's made so many clutch kills, clutch gibs. He's just played perfectly. And I'd have to say Mouse is MVP.
Mouse is MVP?
I'd definitely vote Mouse MVP if there is an MVP vote.
Who was your most surprising player of the LAN? The player who shone out the most, you would never have even considered to be a good player.
That's a pretty difficult question. I don't really know.
Well, I reckon for me...
I think
me,
Overboost, probably, because Overboost wasn't even playing, and now he's absolutely...
That's a good
he
point.
Went absolutely sick. So to go from not even playing to 9th in one day is pretty good, I think.
I'd
say Overboost, yeah.
And he also won a mousepad.
Yeah, he did.
Unbelievable.
UCK. SteelSeries heavy. Yeah.
There you go then. I think we're going to be coming up with some more of the COD tournament now at Sage. And from us guys here in the ET tournament, Nexus are going to take home first place. Dignitas are going to take second place. And Evo are going to take home the third place. And from us here at the ET event, catch you soon. And hope you enjoy the COD 4 event now.
Yep. Will there be a prize ceremony?
What's up?
Would there be a prize ceremony or?
I'll have to check with Sean's there. I imagine they'll say that on the COD stream or something.
Okay, cool. Well, thanks for watching. See you guys later.